We're going to study the muscles of the face. The first is the occipital frontalis. This occipital frontalis has two portions, an anterior portion and a posterior portion. We're just going to focus on the anterior portion, otherwise referred to as the frontal belly. This muscle right through here. Its action is it's going to draw the scalp anteriorly. It's going to raise the eyebrow superiorly. And when it does that, it's going to create a wrinkle across the skin of your forehead, as you look like when you're surprised. Next, we're going to go to the corrugator supercilii. It's going to be this muscle right through here. It draws the eyebrow inferiorly. It's going to cause a vertical wrinkle of your forehead. Next, it's going to be the orbicularis oculi. That's going to be this muscle right through here. Its main purpose is simply to close your eyeball. Close the muscles of the eye so you can't see your eyeball anymore. Next, we're going to go to the orbicularis oris. It's this muscle right around your mouth. I say it's where the Oreos go. It's going to close the mouth. It's going to protrude the lip outward, as in like when you're making a kissing face. And then when you speak, it's going to shape the lips. So like when people can read your lips when you're speaking. If you can see, Charles is doing it in the background right now. It's kind of funny. Okay. Next, we're going to go to zygomaticus major. It's going to be this muscle right through here. It's going to draw the angle of the mouth superiorly, as in like when you're smiling. Next, we're going to go to the buccinator. So we're going to go to the side. And the buccinator is this deeper, thick muscle. It's going to compress as in when like you're blowing, like blowing bubbles. Sucking as in like when, let's say, you're eating like a lollipop or whistling. And it's going to assist in chewing, mastication. Next, we're going to go to the resorius. This is more superficial. The resorius muscle, it's going to draw the angle of the mouth. So like this corner, it's going to draw it laterally. As like when you're grimace or like a forced smile. Next, we're going to go to the mentalis. The mentalis is going to be right here. It elevates and protrudes the lower lip. So this lower lip right here. And it pulls the chin skin in a pout. So it's going to actually move the skin that would be covering right through here. Next, we're going to go to the depressor anguli oris. That's going to be tagged on this side. But again, you're going to have both on each side. It's going to draw the angle of the mouth laterally and inferiorly as in opening the mouth. So it's going to make it go like this, like down over here in this angle. Next, we're going to talk about the masseter. And the masseter is going to be this big muscle right through here. So for this one, we do want you to know the origin, and we do not want you to know the insertion and action. So its origin is going to be the maxilla and the zygomatic arch. Hint, that's right up through here. Next, we're going to have you know its insertion. So it's going to be the angle and the rhombus of the masseter. It's going to go down here. And if you didn't guess it, it's going to elevate the mandible as in closing your mouth. So it's going to move it up and down, up and down. Next, we don't have platysma, but if you saw a diagram, it's going to be a thick, it's laterally, it's pretty wide, and it's going to cover over this sternocleidomastoid. And so the masseter, or sorry, probably the platysma, the only thing we want you to know is that it draws the lower lip inferiorly and posteriorly. So it's actually going to cover this, and it's going to pull it down and back. And one last structure, it's kind of the muscle that moves the head. It's going to be this one right here, and it's the sternocleidomastoid. It's going to originate down here from the sternum and the clavicle, and it's going to it's going to insert up here to the mastoid process, which is at base of the skull, the temporal bone, and the occipital bone. And it's going to allow the flexion, so it's going to allow you to pull the head, flexion, and then rotation of that.